Hat schon zwei European-Tour-Sieger einfahren können, stand in einem Major-Finale, hat Premier League gespielt, ist aktuell die Nummer 27 der Welt. The Hurricane K.Huybrechts! K.Huybrechts nimmt es auf mit einem Mann aus den Top 10. Er ist die Nummer 9 der Welt. Er hat schon 9 Major-Sieger einfahren können. Ein European Tour-Titel war auch mit dabei. Und er hat zuletzt 3 Pro-Tour-Events innerhalb von 8 Tagen gewonnen. Der Mann ist on fire. The Machine, James Wade.
More games to come this afternoon. Adrian Lewis, a two-time world champion, takes on Madhouse Richie Edhouse in the final game. But this one promises much. We've just seen an incredible display from Dave Chisnell, who's averaged 109 in battering Aaron Monk, who was excellent himself, just not quite excellent enough. And James Wade, the reigning European champion, he's up against the top player from Belgium, the Hurricane K.Huybrechts. 109 average from Chizzy. Wadey has hit more than that in the Premier League already this year. He's hit numbers around that 109-110 mark 3 times in tour events so far this year. And he has only lost 1 of his last 24 matches in all competitions. James Wade is one of the form players on the planet right now, as the European champion looks to add to his European Tour tally. He does, of course, have a couple of these titles. But K.Huybrechts is a man who's got a couple himself.
First leg, it's James to throw first. Game on.
I call a Kirk Bevins gets us underway. Rob Mullarkey is in the comms box.
Really looking forward to this one. James Wade, an incredible run of form. The 9-time major winner 60. Has won 5 of the last 21 PDT tournaments in the past 6 months. And in the period since he ended his near 5-year drought for a big TV title at the European Championship, he is right now the joint most prolific tournament winner on the PDC circuit alongside Michael van Gerwen. Unbeaten in 16 matches. You just wonder, when will it end? James Wade just seems to be on the crest of a very big wave right now, but K.Huybrechts, a tough opening assignment for him. Kim coming through his first match yesterday against Dragutin Horvat. Only just 60. As well, you might argue. He had to work very hard. He had to dig very deep, and he came through with an average of 93 and a bit.
91.
He will need to improve today if he's to challenge James Wade here.
Yeah, you would think so. And this is the half of the draw away from Michael van Gerwen. The top seed in this half of the draw, Ian White, has already been knocked out as well.
100.
The winner of this one will face either Keegan Brown in good form or Max Hopp, winner of course on the European Tour last year, as well as another tour event last year.
105.
Now the kick, 70 required to break the Wade throw, no less. Only one dart at his favourite, double 16.
38. Danger Aguirre, 36. Shot the first leg.
Wade draws first blood.
Second leg is Kidd to throw first.
Well, these two know each other inside out. They've met on 22 occasions, as far as I can tell, and Wade has won 17 of them. Not quite the dominance over Michael Smith that he's enjoying right now, but pretty close to it. They've met twice this year, both on the Pro Tour in the Players' Championship Series, both of them in Wigan. Wade winning one of them 6-2 and the other was 6-5 with averages of 98 and 90 respectively.
Yeah, both first round games as well, which illustrates how K.Huybrechts no longer a seed for those tournaments, and you have 32 seeds in those floor events, so it kind of illustrates how Kim has really dropped off over the last 18 months or so. But if anything can rejuvenate the Hurricane, you would think it's these Euro Tour stages, because if a man who's only won four titles, he's got four PDC titles, but two of them have been on the Euro Tour.
So if you're unseeded, you can only have a maximum of two matches against a fellow unseeded player before you eventually have to come up against a seed.
Well, it depends if they get knocked out.
Yeah, unfortunate for Kim that he has encountered Wade on the Pro Tour this year, because more often than not, James Wade has been doing plenty on it.
Yeah, kind of weird that, I mean, prior to their two meetings this year, both in February, it was only 8 days apart.
100.
They haven't met since
32.
2 years ago.
I'm trying to find, 2015 for their most recent meeting on the European Tour as well, as Huybrechts levels things up. They met in the semi-finals in Sindelfingen. And it was Huybrechts who came out on top that day, en route to the title.
180!
And of course they have crossed swords on the Premier League stage as well.
96.
Over the course of both 2015 and 2017. Backed up by just the 60 for Wade.
James Wade flying high in this year's Premier League, looking very, very likely at the moment to go on and make the playoffs and potentially win the title 10 years after he first won it. That's the thing. James Wade, at the minute, you just look at him and you see him chucking in massive averages. You see him winning game after game after game. He has the benefit of years and years and years of top-level elite darts experience, and yet he's only in his mid-30s.
Yeah.
I mean, what more do you want as a recipe for a man who could go and win anything over the next few years?
Yeah, it's an interesting one, that, as well, because when you look at it from Wade's perspective, he said recently that, he said, when you get to my age, and he is only 36, but my age, and you haven't played so well for 5 years, it's really special to win back-to-back titles. This was in the aftermath of his success last weekend. He's been at the top for, 15 or so years now, and he feels that the best may be yet to come. And on the evidence of what he's doing so far this year, you'd have to go along with that as well.
Yeah, I mean, he's a mess of contradictions at times, James. You'll say one thing to him, and you say you're playing really well at the minute, and he'll just go, no, I'm not.
60.
And then if you say, well, do you not think you're playing your best? And they go, I think I'm playing better than ever. Like, you just genuinely don't know how he rates his performances. Sometimes he'll tell you he used to be a much better player, but other times he says he's much more dangerous now. So what are you to make of this? All you can go on is what he's doing. And the fact he picked up two big TV titles back in last year. He's done the double, winning two over a weekend, which is a tough feat, although Gavin Price has done it this year.
57.
But he just looks... he also believes, which is an interesting thing, he said on Thursday night after smashing Peter Wright in the Premier League, he says of all the players in the Premier League, he believes he's got more chance of beating Michael Van Gerwen than anybody else right now. He believes in himself.
And it was interesting as well, in the aftermath of that win against Peter Wright, he said, as soon as I've seen the wobble factor on the right darts, he said, I knew I had him 100%. So there was a focus for James Wade, and he seized on it.
Seized
on that double 20, though.
Kind of expected it. Everything went according to plan, and then he's just above the top wire. Double 16, double 8, have not been as reliable. To K.Huybrechts this weekend. He was missing quite a bit against Dragutin Horvat. Nearly cost him the game.
Certainly did, Dan. Absolutely right. He was 6 from 25 on his doubles yesterday. K.Huybrechts. That's not the sort of standard. Well, it's good enough for Karol Sedláček, by the way, who was 6 from 30 in his opening win against Ian White.
Dreams of 6 from 25, Karol Sedláček.
You know, staggering figures. But yeah, 6 from 25 against Horvat. I think he'll have to. Well, he won't get away with that today.
96.
Yeah, we have seen half of these seeded players in action so far today go out of the tournament. The ferret, Johnny Clayton, the diamond, Ian White, and Noppy, Danny Nopper, all beaten in contrasting fashions, it has to be said. But there have been some pretty impressive displays from the other seeds, Darren Webster, Daryl Gurney, and of course Dave Chisnell. All of them
140.
Putting in strong displays. 97 averages for Webster and Gurney, and then that 109 from Dave Chisnell. And James Wade has started this one very much as you kind of expect him to, with a mid-90s average, 50% on his doubles, not panicking, and on course to win it 6-4 with an average 1 point above his opponent. Oh, he's gone for it!
42.
Really thought he was going to lay up there, but that's how he's feeling. He's confident.
Yeah, on a weighting scale of 1 to 10, where are we right now, Hidan?
Look, this is going to be 5 for double 10, for 3-2. There is not. I don't think there's anybody in the world more confident than James Wade of being involved in a close game like this, where it feels nip and tuck, and other players can get edgy and nervous, and James Wade is quite happy. He's completely happy in this situation. He actually came off against Peter Wright on Thursday night, having won 8-2, and he didn't realise until halfway through his interview that he was doing with him that he'd won 8-2. He thought it was 8-5. He said, oh, it wasn't very good. So he's won that 8-2. He's like, he got five legs. It's like, no, he didn't. He absolutely coasted it. Because he's unaware. He's just going about, he's just win this leg, just keep plodding on, nose ahead, doesn't matter. It's an incredible sort of mindset, this zone that he gets into in games. And that is one of the things that allows him to perform in those big moments, the wading moments where he needs to take out those checkouts. He's able to just go through the normal processes and treat it as if it was any other moment.
He does strike me as somebody who can just shut out a lot of things that are going on around him as well. Very difficult to do as well.
Yeah.
It's something he has spoken about before. You know, there's a lot going on for Wade when he's on stage, and he's spoken quite openly and quite, well, frankly, about what sort of a mindset he has when he's up there.
136 a little bit too much for him, but a single 16 leaves tops. 96. And now the pressure is put on to K.Huybrechts to see if the Belgian can deal with it. It's a double 8.
Yeah, there we see the doubles just coming to haunt K.Huybrechts once again. And Wade, in typical ruthless fashion, pounces all over that one and takes out tops. And he just establishes that little bit of daylight and throwing first now for a 5-2 lead. 6 finals last year for James Wade, so you could argue that what he's doing so far this year had been coming.
43.
Although he lost the first 4 on the Pro Tour, 2 in Europe, and then he had the big ones, the European Championship finals and the World Series of Darts finals back-to-back weekends late on. Terrific time of the year for him. Huge amounts of prize money.
And look, there was some really good stuff in those, but he had more than his fair share of fortune in winning those titles, but look what he's done given that platform. You know, the last 2 weekends on tour where he's picked up 3 of the 4 titles, and the Premier League stuff from recent weeks, There's not been any fortune about that. He's been averaging 109, 110, 102. The rest of the time, it's mid to high 90s. And here we go with James Wade. Scoring easily. This is, the average is now lifted up to the 100 mark. And this is the stuff that some of Wade's detractors say he doesn't score well and can't do it.
This is
nonsense.
This is it as well. I mean, his recent successes, we'll just see if Wade can take this out, by the way. Well, he will have to return because 58. K.Huybrechts is on 252. No doubt about it, his recent success has been built on a very high standard of darts. And people will say, well, he's had a couple of rough rides and a couple of scares, but you're going to get that because the standard's so high. Double 10. I mean, Ted Evans took him to a deciding leg. Came through that. Wade just opens the door, though, for K.Huybrechts here momentarily.
Great dart. Just stick in there. Oh, Kim.
Now those woes of yesterday are back to haunt him once more. And Wade, double 10.
Oh, no score.
He's busted.
Wow.
Kim Yuguan,
yeah, that one doesn't count.
Playing as Joker.
Double six. Double three, around the board we go. Kim K.Huybrechts rescues it last dart.
Gets away with that one.
He lets Kim to throw first.
Yeah, credit to him. That was a big dart for K.Huybrechts. Wade left to reflect on the one that got away.
Game on.
It's the most common bust we see in PDC darts, going for double 10 and hitting double 15 by accident. But James Wade is not a player you expect to do. You don't expect any of them to do that. But of all people to do it, James Wade is not the one who's made a living out of beating people by hitting double 10. But again, he's not going to panic.
57.
He's just going to carry on going about his business. And I mean, he says sometimes, oh yeah, it's, I've got a calm facade.
137.
You know, I am really nervous. You don't get any impression that that's the case.
You might see the occasional grimace and the occasional,
he does a bit of mugging for the camera every now and again. But
but yeah.
48.
Quarter final appearance for Wade at the start of the Euro Tour campaign in Leverkusen. Beaten in round three in Hildesheim by Darren Webster in a match in which he threw a nine dart leg, the second that we've seen on the Euro Tour this year.
140.
Yeah, coming to the Euro Tour expecting nine darters every weekend.
Well, we've had two from two, so you know, we have to maintain this average that has been set.
5 years without one, maybe 5 years we get on every event. I'll take that.
57.
I assume this will be treble eight for tops for Wadey.
Well, again, he won't be panicking too much because this is on the K.Huybrechts' throat and he might well get an opportunity anyway. Because K.Huybrechts' finishing has not been convincing, but it's convincing there. And we are level once again at four apiece.
Wow, fired up Kim K.Huybrechts. Just taking out the 76, the highest checkout we've seen in the game so far. The crucial ninth leg, so often pivotal in these best of 11 clashes.
100.
And K.Huybrechts is having a good go here, a real good go.
140.
Yeah, I think he's just a little bit encouraged by the fact he has been able to rescue the situation as far as the finishing is concerned.
140.
Ooh, Kim.
80.
Well, he does get himself down to a finish, but was that a real opportunity that's just slipped by? Because Wade is going to leave himself.
105.
Couple of darts for the leg. K.Huybrechts can't take 1-4-1. And Wadey had a real mess in that seventh leg.
65.
He missed one dart in the last leg. But with two darts in his hand, he gets the job done.
He's back where he wants to be. Max Hopp or Keegan Brown await the winner of this one. And it's by no means certain who is going to win this one, because K.Huybrechts is still in there and he's still posting big numbers and he's still very much involved, especially if Wade fails to find a big number here, and it's a sluggish start to this 10th leg for him.
Well, we've seen on many occasions James Wade in this position just go, right, well, you have the leg, I've got the throw in the last leg decider and I know that the game is still in my control.
140.
How much would this mean to K.Huybrechts, though, if he were to come through?
Well, it'd be huge for a guy who has not had the best of times.
83.
For some while now, we saw an incredible display from him in his opening game at the World Championship, but then couldn't follow up with a great deal. This year, there have been odd wins here and there, but he's still searching for a first quarter final of the year. Double 19, he could split it. Yeah, decides to split it to leave that double 16, and he's still 66. Struggling on that double 16.
Give me Rubois 32. Yes, on the 10th there, K.Huybrechts.
Well, we are going all the way, just as these two did earlier this year on the Pro Tour. It was Wade who came out on top that day, 6-5.
100.
Well, the king of the last leg decider for many years was James Wade, and he's won plenty of them. He's won a fair few recently as well.
I was just going to say as well, these two have, three occasions these two have played a 6-5 match. Guess who's won all three of them?
In this little run of form over the last couple of weeks, James Wade has had 6-5 wins over Ted Everts, Luke Woodhouse, Joe Mernon, Adrian Lewis. If it goes close and it's with James Wade, you had better produce something spectacular, because he may only need one dart.
140.
And he's given himself a chance at that 161. Needs a treble, Kim. Has to force Wade to at least go for the 161 checkout.
58.
And he can't do it.
161.
Well, six darts for Wade from here.
Well, 54. Well. It's a very James Wade finish, that 107. Very James Wade. It'd be the most archetypal Wade thing to win 6-5 with 107 checkout. But can he do it? He can't. Match start missed, and K.Huybrechts could knock out the European champion.
He's looking now at double eights, and there's no problem this time for K.Huybrechts. It was a concern earlier for him, and it certainly was a concern yesterday. And K.Huybrechts has seen off the European champion, and James Wade, after this astonishing run, 16 matches unbeaten. That run comes to an end here at the German Darts Grand Prix, and that is the biggest upset of the afternoon so far. Okay, Ian White, the number two seed, has also fallen by the wayside, but the way that Wade has been playing, the form he's been in right now, that has to go down as a massive, massive scalp for K.Huybrechts, and that will mean a great deal to the Hurricane, who goes through to round three to face either Max Hopp or Keegan Brown tomorrow. Congratulations to him, but it's another early exit on the European Tour stage for James Wade. Beaten in the third round in Hildesheim, beaten in round two in Munich. Congratulations to K.Huybrechts, safely through just about 6-5 into round three.
Kim, congratulations. That is one of the best at the moment, James Wade, and you beat him.
Yeah, I have a lot of respect for James, what he's doing lately. He's, like I said, he was well, out of form, and everybody wrote him off, and now he's one of the best players in the world again, and to beat him here on this stage feels really good.
Yeah. Yesterday you told us vegetables, that's the thing. How many kilos did he eat?
I just had breakfast, that's it. There's no vegetables in breakfast, so no, I'm really happy. I'm playing well the whole year, playing good, but it's always close, and now finally I won this first one, close, win it, happy, good.
If you ask me, the fire is back in your face, in your eyes, so the enjoy is back, is that right?
Yeah, the fire is always there, but you have to play good to create more fire. And I wasn't playing good in the past, but it's going good again. The fire is coming back, and that combination is lethal.
See you tomorrow. Thank you very much. K.Huybrechts, der strahlt aus allen Poren, der freut sich über diesen Erfolg. Er sagt, das ganze Jahr ist schon gut und die Motivation ist da, das Feuer ist zurück. Aber du kannst es auch erst entfachen, wenn du dann auch den Erfolg hast. Was für ein schöner Sieg für den Mann aus Belgien, aus Antwerpen, K.Huybrechts. Ihn sehen wir morgen also wieder, Achtelfinal-Session.